It's the first time since the general election of 2019 when we finally sent that corduroid communist cosmonaut into orbit where he belongs. And we knew that some people would still be anxious. So we sent top government representatives to our sweatiest boîte de nuit to show that anyone could dance perfectly safely. And wasn't he brilliant, my friends? Let's hear it. Let's hear it for John Bon Jovi. You know those people gluing themselves to roads? I don't call them legitimate protesters like some Labour councillors do. I think some Labour councillors actually glue themselves to roads. I say they're a confounded nuisance who are blocking ambulances, stopping people going about their daily lives. And I'm glad Pretty is taking new powers to insulate them snugly in prison where they belong. Is it not a sublime irony? Is it not a sublime irony that even in French politics, there is now a leading centre-right politician calling for a referendum on the EU? Who is now calling for France to reprendre le contrôle? It's good old Michel Barnier. That's what happens. That's what happens if you spend a year trying to argue with Lord Frost, the greatest frost since the great frost of 1709. Beavers that have not been seen on some rivers since Tudor times, massacred for their pelts and now back. And if that isn't conservatism, my friends, I don't know what is. Build back beaver, I say. In his final absurd act of opportunism, he decided to oppose step four. He opposed step four of the roadmap in July, remember? That's right, folks. If we listened to Captain Hindsight today, we'd still be in lockdown. We wouldn't have the fastest growth in the G7. If Columbus had listened to Captain Hindsight, he'd be famous for having discovered Tenerife. How utterly astonishing.